States for helping create a nationwide opioid epidemic that's killing more than 100 Americans a day. Emails revealed in the case show executives complaining about sales targets and pushing for bigger profits. Pro-wall Republicans often say that even one life lost to an illegal immigrant is too many. And they're right. Every death is a tragedy. Which is why it's worth noting that at the dawn of the opioid epidemic, when 59 deaths were reported in a single state, Purdue's president wrote, quote, "This is not too bad. Could have been far worse." So don't get fooled by fact-free fear-mongering. It's clear that when you look at the actual facts about dangerous drugs, the walls that matter most are the ones around the minds of people who think that only a complete physical barrier between the U.S. and Mexico will solve the problem. And that's your reality check.
John, we're going to need to do that reality check for as long as the people who keep using that falsehood keep making it.
Well, it's every day.
I know that.
I mean, it's every day.
Every day this week, so far.
Keep hitting repeat on that one.
Okay. Thank you very much.
All right, more than a dozen black employees, half a dozen black employees at General Motors say they are facing racist threats and intimidation at work. Their evidence is laid out in a lawsuit with pictures of nooses, whites-only signs, and the N-word they say showed up inside the plant. While GM says it takes discrimination and intimidation seriously and is doing all it can to get rid of the problem, a state law enforcement agency had ruled that it's not doing enough. Sinan Sarah Seidner has more in our series, State of Hate. Sarah.
Yeah, John, you know, look, several black employees at the GM plant say that racist intimidation and discrimination actually made them fear to go to work. And that intimidation has not stopped even to this day. Should also mention that in this story, you are going to hear some disturbing language. There are some racial epithets. We're trying to explain to you what exactly is happening with these employees.
Every day he walked into work, Marcus Boyd prayed he'd survive his shift unscathed.
I felt like I was at war, risking my life every day.
Derek Brooks, a former Marine, worked in the same place. Both were supervisors on different shifts at the General Motors transmission plant in Toledo, Ohio. Brooks considers himself tough from his military training, but he struggled to handle what was happening at work.
How rough and tough can you be when you got 11 or 12 people who want to put a noose around your neck and hang you till you're dead?
There's a reason he brings up nooses. It's not just a figure of speech.
This is the picture of the noose that I found the night that I was at work on my shift.
According to a lawsuit now pending against GM, this is one of at least five nooses discovered at their workplace in separate incidents. The suit also claims there were signs that blacks were not welcome there. Whites only scrawled on a bathroom wall, along with